Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Wales Campaign Party 11. Now some of you are probably, well, you've probably noticed already, because these episodes have basically been released weeks after I recorded them, and the first episode, as of recording this episode, part 11, has gone live, and a couple of you have noticed that the music is actually quite low. Which it would have been low in the first 10 episodes, actually, but I've actually gone into the settings and I've changed things now, so as you can probably hear now, there is some music in the background, so that would help things a little bit. And also, I've turned the gain up to about half now on my Blue Yeti microphone, so we should have better audio quality as well. So let me know in the comments, you know, what this sounds like right now, because I'm going to go with this kind of setup for this campaign. But anyway, that's enough talking. In the previous episode, we took Shaftesbury and we took Winchester. Oh no, sorry, we already had Shaftesbury. We took Winchester and we took Launceston. So now we are looking very good. We have taken a lot of the southern settlements from England and we are pushing on. We are besieging Nottingham. Look at that. Look at that bullshit. We are taking Nottingham. We can get some mercenaries. We can get some Sherwood archers. Holy crap. They're not worth it though. They are definitely not worth it. Get these Scythewyr bowmen every time. They are much better. And we can actually assault them. So let's go and assault the English at Nottingham. Here we go, lads. Here we go. Oh, and Edmund, he's actually... Oh, my goodness gracious me. He's actually got a better ratio, but we're going to fight this battle. So let's go onto the battlefield and take up arms against our English foes. Huzzah. Yeah, so the music, you can hear it now. So, yeah, I think what happened is I turned it down in my headset and I'd kind of... thought that it was picking up and it actually wasn't. It was there, but it was just so low you probably couldn't hear it unless you had very good acute hearing, but you can hear it now anyway. So here we are, the Wales campaign back for you guys to enjoy. Huzzah. Right, let's get all these dudes into position. Let's get all these other dudes into position. Group up the spearman like so. Get the bowman. Get the bowmen into position. Get them into a nice position behind. Get these axemen on the wing. Get the general to position. I think that's everyone. Give me a hell, give me a yeah. We're actually gonna send these axemen up into this gatehouse, I think. Ooh, what do we have here? There are armored sergeants, spearmen versus axemen. Ooh, we'll see who wins, but we're gonna go for it straight away, lads. We're going to go. Can't actually run with these, unfortunately. It's going to be quite a slow pace, and my bows could actually aim fire upon our English friends at the tower at the top, which I think we will do actually. But I'm actually going to just do it with the two Scythewyr bowmen, because, well, I'll tell you why now. Basically, Scythewyr have better range than Hellwyr bowmen, and what we will be doing by doing that is they won't be in range of their towers. So if I pull them back, so as you can see, these towers can't hit these at the moment. They're going for the siege weaponry anyway. But here we are, we're getting some shots away now. Look at that ridiculous bullshit. We're attacking the English on the wall. Oh crap, I zoomed in too far then, and we're not doing very good, which is a shame. But we are attacking the English at the wall. We're going up the ladder right now, aren't we? Yes, we are. We are going up the ladder. Nice bum. Up the ladder we go. We're going to attack the sergeant. Attack the armoured sergeant at the top. Actually, these are Hellwyr bowmen can attack the English armoured sergeants to reinforce slightly. Reinforce our axemen. Our beautiful, beautiful axemen. And we are ramming Ziget house.
The battering ram is in place. It'll not be long before our enemy's defences fall.
And basically what I can do with this one unit of Gwent Raiders is settle down. Gwent Raiders are fantastic units in my opinion. They are one of the most oh shit, what's going on? Dude, why aren't you attacking this gate? Attack the gate, damn you. Did I click the wrong one? I clicked the wrong one. Holy crap, I failed. Does not matter. We are in a good position. We have killed one man from this armored swordsman, so that's very nice. And we are attacking the spearmen, but victory, oh shit, victory is impossible. We've lost. We have lost one of our Hellwyr heavy infantry, so that is ridiculous bullshit indeed. We have spearmen though, which we can utilise, and we do outnumber the English, I think. Now, where's the capture point? I think it's over here. Nope, that's just the general. Capture point must be... Oh my god, where's the capture point? You know, I'm not actually sure where the capture point is. I'm thinking it might be... Oh, I know where it is. It's actually one of these type of... Yeah, you've actually got two gates. Jammy bastards. They have two gates. Good thing we got two battering rams. We are 96%. Oh, we're nearly in, Oh, we are in. Look at that.
The gates have fallen.
We are in. And we shall be attacking this Spearmon. Let's get my Spearmon into position. And let's get our Gwent Raiders grouped up. Get them charging in with axes flying. And where's that cavalry unit gone? Our Spearmen can be sent to attack them. So we'll get a Spearman into the settlement. We're just going to go straight for the cavalry with the Spearmen. Click an early move order. Oh my crap, look at this. They are burning some of my men, which is not good. We are firing our bows. Our bows are firing, and we are taking out some, but not all. Only a few of them are dying, which is bad. But they are dying, which is the main thing. And then we have this unit here, 56. So we've taken some of them out today, and what do we have here? More Armored Sergeant. So they've got them all on the walls, which is rather foolish in my opinion, because we can hit them up the bum. That's what exactly what we're going to do. We're going to get our heavy infantry, charge our heavy infantry, and get it in there, lads. Run, run, you fools. General, get up your... Get the general up. Everybody's going to be attacking. Oh, ducky, ducky, ducky. What the fuck? What the hell's going on up here? Ridiculous bullshit. Here we go, Spearman. Go and sit for the charge, and the general's running away like a fool. Like the fool that he is. And we have 50, 66 and 58. 58 Spearman can turn around. This is where we now start attacking the armoured Spearman against our own Merinoid Spearman. Come on, I must take Nottingham. This is not good enough. We must take the knots. Right, my general can charge. I won't charge them because they are Spearmen. So our general can actually continue with the assault by going for their general. Reinforcing my Spearmen, and we can charge our Spearmen into the armoured sergeants there. Now these units, holy shot, what the hell's going on here? What in the blazes is this? Gwent Raiders are up on the top. They are fighting. Victory is almost certain.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
We must smash. Smash. Smashy smash smash. Bowman can get in. Gonna change. I'm gonna throw the bowman into the settlement. Along, yes, all the bowmen can get into the settlement. The French accent is coming out. Oh, and they have some heavy bill militia, which we're gonna charge with the general. Holy shit, look at this. Look at it. Charge! Holy crap, but you're dead. You must be dead after that. They're gone, one charge, and they're all gone. And that's how it's done, out in Wales. They're all dead. We've won this little battle up here, so we'll stay up there now because we've got the general to take out as well. Should have enough men to deal with these, although I don't trust them, so my general come to help, because victory is a distinct possibility for the English still, which is not good for me. So our bows can actually continue to fire and rain death upon the English scum that they are. Oh, and they have lots of them up here, actually, which I didn't notice. I didn't see that, so... Oh, crap. Gwent Raiders, get in here, man. Axemen are doing some damage, which is fantastic. See, General can give a rallying cry. Spearman 59, Spearman 63. We need to help out these dudes over here. General with a charge! Right into the rear, which would cause some conflict, I would assume. Don't want to stay too long because they have Spearmen and we don't want to get involved with Spearmen. So get our bums up here. Get over there, lads. And my other Spearman unit, where are you gone? Dudes, you can get up here quickly, because we are losing. We're starting to lose. Oh, what the hell, you're just standing outside the gates like a bunch of morons. Get in, you fools. Don't stand out there for too long. Just not good enough. Oh, man. Where's my general? General's here. He's gonna go for a little charge. 28 of them remaining, so we should be okay. Bows, all bows can attack this unit. Because why the hell not? General's going for another charge, look at that. Holy crap. Now they should break. Defeat's a distinct possibility. Defeat is now certain. Nice little charge in the rear does wonders sometimes. And we are, of course, reinforcing with our spearmen, which have intercepted the armoured sergeants. And our general is going to do a little bit of a pull through with Merinoid spearmen charging in the rear and Gwent Raider supporting. Look at this crap. Holy crap. General go for another charge in the rear. They're held up ready for a charge. Let's get a nice little angle on this. Holy crap. Not the best of charges. Although we have weakened them very much so. They have lost half their men. Totally outflanked. Pull the general out. General's only got 7 left, so we need to be careful with him, of course. But it's okay. We can support with the Merinoid spearmen. Only 9 spearmen remaining here. I'm going to form up with the remaining 5 units that I have left of the general's unit. This is going rather well, I think. We are doing a particularly good job at the moment, although there are heavy infantry on the walls we need to be a bit wary of, I think. So let's get the Hellweird Bowmen actually inside the settlement, and we'll form a... Oh my god, let's form them up like so. This is a bit dodgy, trying to form up like this. And the general can actually charge the 3 of the remaining here. Now they'll be formed up. There we go, little charge. 5 remaining. Another rallying cry as well. We need the rally. And there's only 3 of them, 2 of them left. So this should... They should be breaking. Why aren't they breaking? This is bad. And of course there's heavy infantry there, which need to be very wary of as well.
Only half our force remains.
Only half our force remains. We are fighting this battle, and we are losing, I think. They're exhausted and they are routing, which is bad. Hopefully the general can give a rallying cry. Get out there, general. Come on. I've lost too many horses, I think. My general needs to get out, though. He can't afford to stay there. There we go. Balabalaba. Holy crap, get out of that infantry battle. Dudes, what are you doing? There we go, the bows are getting out of there now. So much fire being rained down upon the English, it's unbelievable. Right, these bow units are going to attack. Oh shit, we want you to fire arrows. Fire your arrows, man. There we go. They are heavy armoured swordsmen, which is fine by me. Building captured the gateway. Building lost the gateway. There we go, we're firing in close range now, so we should be doing damage. And the general is in a position to attack from that flank if need be. This is very, very tight now. We have Gwent raiders all over the place attacking, up on the walls, fighting them. We're kind of pinning them down, and hopefully we can... As a matter of fact, we will go for a charge in this position. All our bows are here. I'm trying to just make sure I know where all my units are. Infantry here, of course. 21 remaining against 21. It's going to be very close, 21 versus 21. Maybe the general could go for a charge from close range. And with the bow fire as well, you would just assume that we should win, but it's going to be tight, I think. Oh, it's going to be very tight. We are starting to rout now. Don't want to throw my general away either, because we'll all rout otherwise. Building lost the gateway. Holy crap. Get the Hellweirs to turn around in that case. And fire from close range on the spearmen. Oh, it's going to be so tight. We're going to lose this one, actually. Shit, man. Shit, 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 shit. Nineteen remaining. Oh, my God. This is bad. Oh, we're not going to win Nottingham. Shouldn't underestimate the power of the dark side. It's not fair. Pick up this gate with one of these Scythewear bowmen. We're actually going to take this gate and try and ram it up to here. That's the plan. We'll cover with the other units if possible. I have no infantry remaining. All my bows must attack this unit to pin them off, while this unit picks the ram up and pushes it for me. We might be able to do something with that. There is a possibility of still winning this, but it's going to be very, very awkward indeed. At the very least, we've killed a large percentage of their force. If we can just get them to rout, that would be something. Time for the general to get involved in an infantry fight. Time for the Hellweir Bowman to get involved in the fight as well. We're actually going to get him in. He's going to fight like a madman. Oh my god. They're not picking the ram up. Right, everyone just get in.
The battle is very much in our favor. If we remain true and steadfast,
holy crap.
Victory will be ours.
Control A for everyone. Break them. Right, that's working. Holy shit, it's working. In that case, pick it up, dudes. The rest can just keep firing upon them. Armored swordsmen. 9 remaining. Cavalry charge. Right, these dudes are going to continue the fight. Oh, what's going on over here? What is going on over here? So my archers are in a position to fire upon them, which I don't disagree with. Just didn't expect it. 19 spearmen, 16 heavy cav. We're going to aim our arrows at the heavy cav from here. We can distract the enemy. I'm going to need to bring the ram instead with this unit because I do need to get, or I do need to think about getting that ram up there. Now, we've killed all them, so my general can scalp over there. These two bow units are going to get into position. I'm going to try and win this with bows and a general, and the general's only got 3 units remaining, so it's going to be very tight. But still possible to take Nottingham from the English, though. I do sense that we are close, with only 2 units remaining, and they've got the armoured spearman on the wall, which is a very, very good idea, unfortunately. It's a very difficult settlement to take, actually, isn't it? Thinking about it. Got walls within walls, and there's just too many walls for me to deal with. Wow. And all my units are gone apart from the bows. Holy crap. We're not even getting shots on the cavalry, we are actually getting them on the armoured sergeants instead, which isn't a bad thing necessarily, but it would be better if we aim for the general's bodyguard, I think, so we probably want to aim for that. Let's get these bowmen into position, get them into a loose formation as well, so they don't take as many hits from arrow fire. General can just wait there for the time being, he can chill. He can chill. We've got the ram coming up with the two, with the scythe-wear bowmen holding it, and then these bow units are going to be coming up not far behind. Hellwear bowmen, which can't get a formation going. Oh, there we go. Got one eventually. They can just walk up while this unit now would fire upon the enemies. Gonna fast forward. Fast forward through the bullshit. Hopefully we can get a few more kills on them. We need to weaken them as much as we can. Basically, use up all our ammunition before we go in. That's all we can do. Unfortunately, those walls are going to cause me lots of trouble. Just get rid of these little messages off the screen. That's fine. And then the ram is getting near, isn't it? Right, these two units now are also going to be firing upon the armored sergeants. If I had spearmen left, I wouldn't be worried about the cavalry, but unfortunately the cavalry probably will cause me some trouble, so we are going to have to be very wary indeed. Bum, 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 bum. We're not getting any kills, unfortunately, which is bad. Hopefully we will now we've got more men firing. And hopefully we can actually get this gate down, because that's my fear at the moment, is that we might lose our ram. Especially if they went for a charge and opened the gates. Come on, dudes, get your kills going. Get your kills. We've got lots of ammunition left between them all, so I'm not too worried at the moment, but it could cause a problem later on, so we need to be a bit careful. Oh, shit. No. Don't destroy the ram, for fuck's sake. I think we're okay. Right, we're going to get in the gate, I think, so we are good. It's 12%, or 10% damage on the ram, 24% on the gate, which is good. And still, we haven't killed any spearmen, so still only 19. Just shows you how useful hiding behind the walls can be. Boom, 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 boom. Right, the gate worked. Now, plan B. Plan B. Drop the siege equipment. Fire arrow straight through. General, get into a reinforcing position over here. 4 units. Thing is, they may come down now, which they are. Perfect. We're actually aiming for the heavy cavalry, the general's bodyguard. If we could kill the general, that would be something. I think they're just going to camp in the center. That's what it looks like where they are going, which I'm happy about because I don't really mind that. We'll just use up all our ammunition and hopefully kill off enough of them. And they're in a much more open position here. Come on, get a few kills for me. All right, we got some. There we go. They've come off the thing and we've actually got a few kills. Hell yeah. All my bows are going to aim for one target. Hopefully we can get some decent kills. Come on, get me some kills. Fast forward. Oops. A little bit of laggy there.
Our army is tiring.
Oh, like that. More arrows, please. So I'm talking about. 11 remaining. They're shaking as well. We can do this. We've got enough ammunition to do this. Down to 10. This is so tight. This is a big grind, this is. Grinding for Nottingham. Probably going to be the name of this episode. 16 generals bodyguard and then 8 spearmen. And the actual general's bodyguard looks like he's going to come out to play now. Which is rather shit for me, so let's get our cavalry up to position. Because that general's bodyguard can fuck me up big time. Ah, shit. Our general died. Oh, mayhem. We're going to lose now, unfortunately. Melee reminds me the mad drunk is finally dead. And we've only killed one horse. Two horses. Still aren't enough. We're losing too many men. Need to get more kills. And they're all gone. Fuck. Bollocks. Shit. Nearly had Nottingham. If only. Probably one more unit would have done it for me. One more infantry unit alive on the battlefield. Ah, man. Men remaining 49 and they still held. Oh, my God.
Sir, we should retreat.
We've still got a chance to take Nottingham, funnily enough. Still a chance to take it. We're going to go back to the fort by the looks of things, so that will do for now. We get free upkeep on these units anyway, and we can hopefully get a few more soon. Although I think we are too far away from any decent kind of reinforcement, so they're on their own basically. But if only I could have taken Nottingham. Could have stayed in Nottingham and rebuilt, and even thought about taking London. This sets me back a little bit now, actually. we are recruiting at Shaftesbury Winchester, which I took as well in this turn, I think. So yeah, we are recruiting some spear militia. We can retrain in the next turn, which we're going to need to do. Because we got catapults, some English build men, but they need to be retrained. We've got some spearmen, but it's a very small force, so we are gonna have to be a bit careful. Bring the general out and then, oop, a little bit of lag. We can't actually get any mercenaries, so that's a bit of a shame as well. I need to think about getting troops to Gloucester, not Gloucester, to Oxfordshire, so just double check a few things and ask for their details. So we are mainly Welsh in Gloucester now, which is good. Shrewsbury's got a decent army which can be used, I think. Matter of fact, let's go for, oh my crap, we can actually get to Oxford with this army. Oxford's got 3 units. We may as well. We're heading to Oxford with Rodri the Honest. And Shrewsbury needs some more forces, so let's just get some English billmen for now, is it? Let's get 2 units of English billmen to help Shrewsbury. And then, of course, we got Ballista, which we can put in Shrewsbury anyway. In case it gets attacked, we've got something to use. Most of these settlements have 1 or 2 units, which are useless, which is fine by me, because they don't need to be reinforced, to be honest. I could actually probably use this catapult at Shrewsbury as well. I'd like to keep one at Montgomery, maybe. Oh, it's pretty in Shrewsbury. We're going to be using them. We're going to use them for an offensive attack anyway. Carlisle is also something which is eluding me at the moment. Although I'm not really in a position to attack Carlisle. I can't recruit anything. I can recruit some Hellwood bowmen, but I'm not going to. Rodri the Honest is going to take Oxford. And in the south, we have... well, we have a peasant army. Let's just use Iago of Ceredigion. Iago can just chase him down. I want to resolve the only peasants. What? We lost? They're fucking peasants. How the hell? Oh my god. What the hell? What in blazes? Use Meridi instead. Look at the balance of power. 100 to 9. Auto-resolve. Right, clear victory. That's where it should have been. Oh my god. The bloody auto-resolve in this game is shit sometimes. Fucking peasants. And we lost. Send the victory for me. Right, so we need to start thinking about this as well. So we are currently upgrading the wooden palisade. And we are constructing a brothel here. Just checking everything that I'm doing. Make sure I'm recruiting decent things. So that army can probably be pushed out shortly. Launceston. Yeah, I need to get a bit more Welsh culture here first before we move out. And then we can perhaps take the fort and move on with this army. Shaftesbury. Now we've got Winchester. I don't have to stay at Shaftesbury. So King Llewellyn can start moving again. And now Shaftesbury is actually happy with me. Oh, it's because I haven't moved the rest of the army. Just move one unit instead, rather foolishly. Oh, they would be quite happy, dishappy, unhappy. What's the worst unit I got? Probably the English heavy billmen. I don't know. So look, 60, 14 attack, total defense. Oh, they get more defense. So it's just English billmen. They're heavy billmen. So put the English billmen back in Shaftesbury, and they're happy. So we can just do that, and King Llewellyn can move on. Attack, Captain. Davy, auto resolve this one. Clear victory, only lost a few. Ransom accepted, get a bit more cash. And we're going to head just outside Winchester. We're going to go there in case we get attacked. We'll have reinforcements. And King Llewellyn's in a good position now to recruit everything at Winchester and push on towards Arundel and then perhaps London. So we're going to come from the south with King Llewellyn. Winchester's going to be recruiting and retraining a few troops for me as well, which we can get some spears and more English billmen. And that's a good idea for me. This episode's going to be a bit longer. I did promise it in the last episode, but then I didn't keep my promise. So I'm going to go for at least half an hour, probably a bit longer in this episode to make up for it. So I'm sorry about that, guys. I do forget these things sometimes. I am human. Somebody commented in the first episode recently as well about Ireland. I think it was Joe Cadden, that he wanted me to get involved with Ireland. I haven't actually seen Ireland in the campaign yet. It's just been all England and a little bit of Scotland. Oh, that reminds me. I think Oh, yes, there they are. The Norwegians. The Norwegians themselves. Let's... is there something I can do? Bribe? I doubt it. Let's go for trade. Which is... okay. Map for map. If we take our map away and just ask for maps demanding. That's good. Go for that. Look at that. We're getting trade with them and we got map information with them. We're getting alliance. Maybe. Generous, but I'm not going to go for it. So close the scroll. I'm really happy with that because we've actually got the mission successful and we've been rewarded with 500 florins from our noble emissary. So we have got our diplomat now up in the north, which we can actually probably go towards Ireland, which of course I don't think we can actually get to because we need a boat, I believe. We can get as far as there. So we're going to head back down with the diplomat, get as far as Carlisle. Yes, sir. With him, and then we'll see how things tomorrow's go there. So we've got some trade, so that's going to help our income. We've got some 500 florins, going to help our income again. So we can start thinking about recruiting some more. Now, Montgomery is the main recruitment centre for me. It has most of the troops that I want, so... oh, it hasn't got Scythewaite or Bowman, though, which I need, so... probably... if I spend 400 florins on another catapult to replace the one which I just got rid of from Montgomery, that would... suffice for now. And then Carnarvon can actually recruit. Yeah, this is the settlement that I wanted. So we can get some Scythewaite bowmen. We'll get one of them. We'll get some mailed knights. Don't want skirmishers. Don't want Marathfell horsemen. I think let's have a look. Mailed knights, attack 8, attack 7, charge bonus is 4, 5, total defense 13, only 11 for them. Armor is 3, defense is 4, defense is 3, shield is 5, shield is 6. So mailed knights are just better in every way. Yeah, we'll get a unit of mailed knights and a unit of Scythewaite bowmen, and they can be shimmied around some Gwent raiders maybe. We'll get a Gwent raider. So we've got 3 units being recruited at Carnarvon. They're going to be linking up with one of the armies that I have, probably Chester or Lancaster. So we have one strong army around about the north there. We'll have one sort of in the mid kind of region of sort of Oxford and Nottingham, and then one sort of Winchester. And then I have other armies then from Launceston, from parts of my Welsh settlements, sort of reinforcing throughout the region. So it'll be three armies altogether. And the southern one's going to be led by King Llewellyn. I'm going to end turn now, so it's going to be turn 14 of the campaign. Oh, my merchant, I forgot to move him. And England have pushed back, I think. They're moving troops around. Oh, they sense a weakness at Shrewsbury by the looks of things. His captain, so we have to be careful. And a captain, a candidate for adoption, Bleddyn Kinfin, confident attacker, promising commander, and a fair fighter. So we'll go for that. A new mission. This region is the frontier to our enemies, but is unmanned and vulnerable to attack. The council suggests you increase our forces here by at least 4 units. So Gloucester needs 4 units now. So we need to recruit 4 units from the recruitment thing. So let's go for cheap units, 2 spearmen, and I'll give one of them and one of them. The good thing is now we're at the stage in the campaign where I can actually recruit and not worry about our finances. That was kind of the point of the first sort of 7 to 8 episodes. Oh, look at that, Norway is in the lead for military. England is still overall, but that's going to change. Because as you can see, our income is 16,000 compared to 12. We're actually making a profit of 4,000. Recruiting things like markets has probably helped that. So Pembroke, for example, we can actually upgrade to a castle. A leather tanner, which would upgrade our padded armour. But I'm not recruiting anything from there, so there's no point. Stuff like communal farming would be useful. Convert to a town would be even better, perhaps. But we're going to go for communal farming for now. These are little things which I can afford at the moment and would actually help our overall kind of money in the long term, our longevity of our campaign. Just going to check something at Launceston now. So if I click on everyone and move them out, Launceston would be a little bit peeved. What if we take just the 2 units and pop them in? Okay, that's not helpful. 17 units of spearmen. It's not helpful. If I lower your taxes, you're still not very helpful. Bit of a shame. I want to move out with this army. I could actually put a Yago of Ceredigion in there. Don't want to give him too many units, do I? I don't want to lose too much. Put 31 spearmen in. Oh, that will do, that will do. I don't want to be too bloody thing, do I? Alright, got Englishman at the fort. I don't know what they have there. We're not going to worry about that too much. English merchant, they need to be wary of him. I got my own merchant on the way, though. He can actually attack this merchant. Oh my god, maybe not. We'll accept the mission anyway, because why not? Although there's a Scottish one there, which is better success rate, so we'll go for the Scottish one. King Llewellyn, take everything from Winchester. Look at that, Winchester looks very nice now. We're going to take, oh god, we want to take these units and attack you. Push you out of my settlement, you bastard. And we will auto-resolve. Clear, lost 7. Ransom rejected, you bastards. Now Winchester is unhappy with me still, but I can of course pull back, so perhaps some English billmen would suffice. We can give you all my English billmen, and then Winchester can actually start recruiting for me while I'm here. Spear militia would do, and some ballista would do as well, funnily enough. And we can actually get a cog as well now, so we can actually get some boats and actually funnel ourselves around a little bit. We can retrain our units, which we can't do at the moment, we just can't do it, but we are nearby King Llewellyn the Honourable. I could assault them straight away, and I could probably take this fort and stay at the fort with Llewellyn, which would be a sensible position, I think. Attempt a knight attack. I don't want to auto-resolve, do I? Do I want to auto-resolve this 5-2? I should win this easily. Especially with our ballista and our bows. I'm going to risk it with an auto-resolve, guys. Automatically resolve. Clear victory, lost 20, that's what I wanted. Ransom, rejected. Taking the fort, that's all I care about. Clear them out of Winchester, we've taken the fort. Free upkeep on these. So again, some free upkeep on some units as well, which is going to help our finances. So make use of these free upkeeps whenever you can. My spy. Oh, we have Rodri. Now we can actually attack this army here, but it's only 4 of them. Not going to cause me too much problem. So I'm going to attack Oxford instead. And apply some pressure on them. Maintain. So we're attacking Oxford now to make them think about that. I know that Captain Arthur has mercenary crossbowmen on the way. So beware of the mercenary crossbowmen. I've got lots of catapults which I can just leave at Shrewsbury. No one wants to attack Shrewsbury with that much catapults. Montgomery needs to get some more troops here, I think. Just go for cheap troops. Just go for spear militia. And then, don't bother about retreating them, for God's sake. Carnarvon has the units that I want, these three, which are all going to be shipped out to Chester. So that's my gift to Chester, those three. So slowly we are building things, and our frontiers are going to be much stronger. We will have the mission completed shortly for Gloucester. We have a bunch of troops on the way. And our money's going to go back down with all these recruitments, so we need to get some more battles on the way shortly. London, Arundel I need to go to as well. Where's my spy? There he is. My spy can go here. There we go, Arundel. Very good chance of us taking Arundel, I think. Only three units there. Yeah, we'll take Arundel and then London as well. My God, taking London is going to be an awesome experience in this campaign, I think. All the units in this fort. Now, this is quite funny because they haven't attacked me. Although they have reinforced Nottingham by the looks of things, because they only had two units remaining. So I could attack them. Anselm of Bapton, I've got his attention, which is quite funny. But I'm actually going to be countering going past Nottingham and causing mischief by drawing them south. Which I can't do, funnily enough. Which is quite funny, but I was hoping that I'd have enough movement points to get around. Doesn't matter. What do they have? Armoured sergeants, lots of them. 75, oh my god. We can't take it with what I have left. We've proven that in the last battle. In the last battle, I actually had a general, so it doesn't matter. I've caused them to... They might attack me, and I could just retreat and pull them out and cause mischief that way. So as long as we're causing mischief, I don't really care. Captain Adaf going to Chester. It's fine by me. Could retrain some English billmen here, or recruit some new ones. We could retrain, maybe. I don't know. I need to start thinking about constructions as well. So Carnarvon has lots of stuff here. I can construct a leather tanner, which would have been useful a few turns ago, actually, for those new units that I recruited. Cardiff, what can I recruit in Cardiff? I can get a leather tanner there. A town hall for the public order bonus and public health bonus, or dirt roads. These are stuff which are not really... I just want the kind of money stuff, really. Montgomeryshire. Can't afford anything at Montgomeryshire because it's too expensive. But you see what I mean? We can get some decent stuff from some of these places. Anyway, we're going to click end turn and continue. So here we go. Our spy's on his way back now. And the English are pushing out of Nottingham. La-dee-dee. Where are they? What are they doing? They're reinforcing Oxford, I think. And they're going to attack me as well, I think. They should attack me. Yes, I think they are. Attack! This is where I retreat. I've pulled enough of them away to cause mischief. I'm just going to withdraw. And I've withdrawn the right way. Oh, we're going to attack me again, are they? Didn't attack me again. Oh, that's good. We've caused mischief, so that's good by me. So end of turn report. There we go. Construction complete. The brothel in Launceston. Recruitment report. We've got some decent units now. This captain, Captain Howell. Let's go to London. Let's cause them to come out of London. I've actually got a trebuchet there, so need to be a bit wary of that. And Llewellyn will probably be pushing out before long. Let's get that ballista in there. Yeah, we're going to get some siege equipment going as well, see. We are a little bit short of units at Winchester, I think, so we need to get some decent ones while we can. The spearmen are probably going to come out with me and the English billmen. Oxford can perhaps be taken. Maybe, maybe not, I don't know. Just thinking at the moment what I have recruiting. So Gloucester's going to be reinforced. Shaftesbury. I could attack this fort. I'm happy to not attack it and carry on. Although I think I need to get past, don't I? Otherwise we're trapped in the south. Let's just push up. With honor, sire. The thing is, I don't have to attack them. They can come out and attack me, so... Armoured sergeants. I'm actually just going to sit outside the fort, see what they have, and just sit there. I don't have to come out. I'm happy to sit at the moment. We can recruit, we can get some half decent units and be happy with what we get that way. So we'll do that. Gloucester's okay. Shrewsbury is fine with plenty and plenty of ballistas, which I'm going to start ferrying out to some of my places now. So take this English fort. Oop, I burped then. Take two ballistas, free upkeep on these ballistas while they're here. I'm going to shift them to probably Rodri the Honest eventually. They can be useful against Anselm of Bapton and Nottingham. We'll break Nottingham with that. These new units from Captain Adaf are going to Chester. Now, Chester has a very good army, so I can probably move everything out of Chester apart from the militiamen. And Chester's actually happy about that, so Yeah, we're just wasting time now with this army.
Your will, sir.
And this army can probably... Tell you what we can do, we can push this army towards Nottingham. Thinking about it, I'm going to do it actually. Vortipa Howell has unfinished business, he's going to do that. And Montgomery is happy enough with them. Carnarvon is happy enough with that. Pembroke, just checking everything quickly. Yeah, so Rodri the Honest, we're going to have a nice battle for Oxford next time, I think. These ballistas will come into play soon. They will be useful. Winchester, free upkeep for the spears. Those English billmen, I could probably keep them there. I need to recruit something here, I think. I don't have... I can't retrain. I can retrain, but I can't actually... Yeah, I can't get any decent units at Winchester, which is a shame. Shaftesbury, on the other hand, I can get some units. So we get Merinoi Spearmen, Gwent Raiders, and English Billmen all at Shaftesbury to help Llewellyn. Reinforce Llewellyn. I'm happy to sit at the fort for now with Llewellyn, I think. That's not a bad plan, actually. We can actually get Edwin Riddick to go to Winchester to keep the peace there. And then we will go for Arundel and then London. We're going to squeeze the life out of England. And it'll certainly give us a lot of pleasure doing that. Captain Howell's going to cause mischief in London, meanwhile. Take the capital off them, that'll be the best. And yeah, we have a nice battle on our hands now for Oxford. So I'm going to end this episode here. I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.